Hello students, so today we will start with the unit 6. The title of the unit is Swarm Intelligence. This is the outline of today's lecture. What is Swarm Intelligence, that is SI? Why is SI interesting for IT? How can we design SI systems? Two principles in SI, self-organization and Stigmergy. Termite example for two principles in SI and conclusion. So let us start. What is swarm intelligence? So the definition by this research scientist, he had defined it in 1999. I will read out for you. The emergent collective intelligence of groups of simple agents, it is called as swarm intelligence, that is SI. So here I would like to give you some examples to convince you about this definition. So you must have seen ants. So ants, they always live in groups, or we call them as ant colonies. Ant don't live individually, so ant always lives in colonies, ant colonies. So how the ants find their food, which mechanism the ants use to find their food and again return to their colony, so it is a group mechanism, or it is a group activity, it is called as group intelligence. It is not the intelligence or the technique by individual ant. So this is called as swarm intelligence. So it is a collective intelligence of groups. Again, one more example, or some few examples I can give, you can say the flocking of birds. So the birds flock together in groups. Then fishing schools, or the fishes, they always swim together. So it is a group behavior. So you must have seen the nests of honeybees. So how the honeybees build the nests is a group technique, or the group intelligence. It is not related to individual honeybee. That is a group activity. So this is nothing but the swarm intelligence. Again, I will read the definition by the scientist. The emergent collective intelligence of groups of simple agents is called as swarm intelligence. So let us go ahead. Some features of SI: autonomy, adaptability, scalability, flexibility, robustness, massively parallel, and self-organization. Let us go through the features one by one. First is swarm intelligence. There is autonomy. The system does not require outside management or maintenance. Individuals are autonomous, controlling their own behavior both at the dictator and the effector levels in a self-organized way. So no external management is needed. You can take any example of like honeybee nest building. So no external external agent it is there in building their nests. So each individual bee is autonomous in itself. Some bees, they are at the dictator end and some are at the effector levels. So again, all these, it is in a self-organized fashion. So this is the first property or feature of SI, that is the autonomy. Very important is no outside agent or outside management. Everybody is in itself autonomous. So that is nothing but autonomy. Next is adaptability. So interactions between the individuals, they can arise through direct or indirect communication. So when you say when you relate it to the insects, So either there is a direct communication or indirect communication through some what you can say liquids they secrete while collecting their food or like that. So this is adaptability. Scalability. SI abilities can be performed using groups consisting of a few up to thousands of individuals with the same control architecture. This is important. Same control architecture. Even if you increase the size, the group, so it is a scalable link. So the same under the same control architecture, you can perform well. This is the specialty of SI. Then flexibility. No single individual of the swarm is essential. That is, any individual can be dynamically added, removed, or replaced. Again, it maps, so it is flexible. This property maps to the definition. So, group, importance is given to group. No single individual is essential. At any time, you can add, remove, or replace. So, when it's a group context, single individual, it doesn't have any value. So, it is a flexible. Next is robustness. No central coordination takes place, which means that there is no single point of failure. So it is a robust, no central coordination. So again, next building example you can take. Nobody is a single point of contact there, not a single B. It is a single point of contact, not a single B is a single point of contact. So no question of single point of failure. So coordination is distributed. Everything happens in a distributed fashion. So again, it maps to autonomy. So no external outside management, individuals are autonomous, but there is no robust, no central point of contact also, so it is a robust. Next is massively parallel. Tasks performed by each individual within its groups are the same. Then self-organization. The intelligence exhibited is not present in the individuals, but rather emerges somehow out of the entire swarm. So again, the importance is given to the entire swarm, that is entire group. Again, some examples of SI. Group foraging of social insects, cooperative transportation, division of labor, nest building of social insects, collective sorting and clustering. These are some examples of SI. Next, why is swarm intelligence interesting for IT? So why to go for swarm? So these are some of the analogies in IT and social insects. So when you think of the IT, information technology, so there some analogies or some similarities are there between the IT and the social behavior of the social insects. So what are these? First is distributed system of interacting autonomous agents. Next is goals are same, performance optimization and robustness. Then next is self-organized control and cooperation, that is decentralization. Then next is division of labor and distributed task allocation. And last is indirect interactions. So all of these points which map to IT, they map to the social behavior of the social insects also. Just now we had seen some examples like ants and honeybees. So why swarm in IT? So it is a mapping of biological swarm to the IT artificial swarm. So why all this swarm and all? So next, how can we design SI systems? So the three-step process is like this: identification of the analogies, understanding, and then engineering. So identification of the analogies. First, you will have to identify the analogies in swarm biology and IT systems. Just now we have seen listed some analogies. You should first identify, then understanding the computer modeling of the realistic swarm biology. So perform or build the first understand how it can be modeled in computer terminology or in IT, and last is then do the engineering, that is model simplification and tuning for IIT applications. So next, two basic principles in SI. First is self-organization and second is stigmergy. So this actually this is the main focus in today's lecture. So we will see these principles with the help of termite nest building example or the algorithm. So let us go to the principles one by one. So first principle of SI, it is self-organization. So some of the properties, again it is a bit redundancy. So no central control, emerging structures, resulting complexity and highly scalable. So no central control, as just now we had seen, no global control, no global information, subsystems perform completely autonomous. Next is emerging structures, global behavior or functioning of the system emerges in the form of observable patterns or structures. So some patterns you can identify in the group behavior or group intelligence. Next is resulting complexity. Even if the individual subsystems can be simple as well as their basic rules, the resulting overall system becomes complex and often unpredictable. Next is high scalability. No performance degradation if more subsystems are added to the system. So performance, it is not at all degraded. System performs as requested regardless of the number of subsystems. So that is, it is highly scalable. Next, some basis methods for self-organization, that is the first principle of SI. So there are three basis methods how this is done, self-organization. First is positive and negative feedback. Second is interactions among individuals and with the environment, and probabilistic techniques. So these are the basis methods how the swarm it is applied, swarm SI, or how this self-organization is actually done, implemented. So positive and negative feedback, simple input processing and output. From output is fed back into the system. So it is a positive and negative feedback. So positive feedback you will get the encouragement, and from negative feedback you will get the corrections, or you can do some corrections and proceed. Next, interactions among individuals with the environment. So three type of interactions: direct communication among the neighboring systems, indirect communication via the environment, it is called as stigmergy, that is the second principle of SI, it also comes here, interaction with or stimulation by the environment, directly with the environment. So this diagram I have taken from this resource, I have given here the reference also. So how the interaction among individuals and with the environment takes place, or three types of interactions as per the previous slide: direct communication, stigmergy, and by the environment. So just focus here. So local work is it is in progress locally. So it is direct communication among neighboring systems. So direct one-to-one communication between the neighboring systems. So local work is in progress. Next is indirect communication via the environment. So this is how indirect communication via the environment takes place, that is stimulation by verb, stigmergy. And last is interaction with the environment. So direct or interaction with the environment, direct interaction with the environment is via signals. So again I will repeat, so this is locally in among the neighbors. So this is indirect via the environment, and this is direct one-to-one to the systems via signals. So this is the second basis for organization, what you can say, second basis for the self-organization. Self-organization is okay, but how it is achieved? First is positive negative feedback, and second, interaction. Individuals should interact among themselves and with the environment, and only some sort of self-organization is achieved. And final is very important, how it is implemented. So some probabilistic techniques are there to implement or to do, or this is a very important basis for self-organization. So we will proceed further. So again, same, this diagram again I am referring from this source. So probabilistic techniques to use, the last basis for self-organization. So example, stochastic processes, random walk you can use, and objective is leaving local optima and stabilization. So it is a nest building algorithm used by termites to collect wood chips. So this is the nest of termites, and this is the pseudocode, nest building algorithm to collect the wood chips. So this is the nest of termites, built by termites. So ensure collection of wood chips on a single heap. So first initialize, and then the algorithm goes in a loop. It repeats random walk until found wood chip. If already carrying a wood chip, then drop the wood chip, else it will take the wood chip, and again it will be in a loop. So this is how the termites, they build their nest using random walk. It's very simple algorithm. So this is such a type of probabilistic techniques they are used to do the self organization. So this is self organization by the termites. Nothing, no external agent is there, or external management coordination or central point of contact is required. So it is by random walk, until they will do the random walk until found the wood chip, like this. So please go through it. Next, second principle of SI, that is stigmergy, we will see. So what is stigmergy? It is stigma plus ergon. So what is stigmergy? Stigma plus ergon, that is stimulation by work. So this diagram again I have taken, referred from the same source. So characteristic of stigmergy: indirect agent interaction modification of the environment. The information is local. It can only be accessed by insects that visit the locus in which it was released, and work can be continued by any individual. So this is the what you can say, how the work is stimulated by the termites. So SI or SI is the pillar construction state, and RI are the responses. So this is how the work is stimulated among the individual termites. So R0, R1, R2, R3 are the responses from the individual termites, and S0, S1, S2, S3 are the pillar construction states. So this is nothing but the stigmergy or the stimulation by work by individual. So finally, starting from S0, S1, S2, S3, finally the nest, full nest of the termites, it is built. So this is the second principle of SI. It is very, last is very important. Work can be continued by any individual. Next, I will conclude now. So in today's lecture, we had seen what is swarm intelligence, and the two principles of swarm intelligence. Again, I will repeat the definition by the scientist, by this research scientist. Swarm intelligence is nothing but the emergent collective intelligence of groups of simple agents. And two principles of swarm intelligence are self-organization, and second is stigmergy. So this ends the today's lecture. Thank you.